for daily Ask Reddit. What very realistic event could happen to make 2020 even worse? The big one finally happens in California that we've been warned about our entire lives. The whole of California quarantines itself by ducking breaking apart from the continent. Edit, some of y'all really don't like California. Grocery stores are forced to close due to employees being infected by the coronavirus. There's always someone who would be willing to take the job, especially with the amount of unemployment coming. Can confirm. Work for an online supermarket. I'm training waiters and chefs to order pick. A much overdue seismic big one hitting my state of California. The last catastrophic quake, as told by several tribes lore, was in the 1700s and created Humboldt Bay. That would suck with everyone being in quarantine right now. We had a 5.2 in Humboldt yesterday. It was quite the fun ride. The coronavirus could mutate to become deadlier, or we could just realize it is deadlier or has long-term effects we didn't know about. This or a rushed vaccine produces rage zombies and we are actually in the precursor to every zombie apocalypse movie ever made. Or they could make an untested vaccine that actually kills 90% of people. Giant forest fires evacuating large parts of California during the escalating coronavirus outbreak. Pretty ironic that last October I was told that I had to leave my house and now being told to stay home. What happens if the coronavirus carries on until wildfire seasons? People would probably be mass tested, and those who test positive would be separated in evacuations and everyone would be evacuated en masse. Well, that would be the optimal solution. Realistically, everyone jumps in their car, create massive traffic jams, tear apart neighboring states' infrastructure, spread the virus to neighboring states and cities, overwhelm the stores, and just stay in hotels. Unexpected solar flare completely shuts down all electronics and internet for a long period would be horrible for the quarantined. I mean, there. That would be absolutely devastating to the medical industry, especially now. Yeah, that would be pretty bad. If all electronics and the internet shut down, think about what you currently have in your possession to offer as trade. Assuming that roving gangs don't just forcibly take it from you first. If an enormous solar flare from the sun strikes Earth, it could take out our electrical grid, internet, and almost all electronic devices. A solar flare stuck in 1859 that would have caused $10 trillion worth of damages today. Fortunately, most internet backbones are in non-conductive optic fiber and are underwater. I actually never knew the internet cabling was run underwater through the ocean until very recently. My friend told me, and I was very skeptical, thinking that'd be an insanely difficult project and extremely expensive, but lo and behold, they're all run underwater. Any disasters during this pandemic? Imagine if this is still spreading rapidly in April with mass quarantines, and a tornado outbreak on the likes of 2011 super outbreak hits. Injured normally have medical to go to, but if it's all filled up by sick patients, well, let's just hope it doesn't come to that. Everyone in the States, count yourselves lucky that this outbreak didn't hit in July to September and hope it gets cleared before then. Imagine if this was widespread during a Category 5 hurricane impact, when they normally tell an entire region to scram to other parts of the country. Edit, I'm well aware of comments regarding Corona still a threat in June to September. You aren't unique. Please stop leaving those comments and instead reply to those that already have done so. Thank you. A coronal mass ejection. There was a huge one in 1859 called the Carrington event. It destroyed telegraph lines. You're probably thinking, oh, those are rare, that'll never happen again. In 2012, a similar sized flare missed the earth by 9 days. If one did occur, we'd only have 17 hours from release to try and minimize damage, and less time if there was a previous smaller CME before a big one which pushed most of the solar wind out of the way. There are more than 3,000 satellites in orbit at the minute. We would lose almost every single one, and the ones that don't decay in their orbits and burn up in the atmosphere might crash into each other, creating a ring of space junk around the Earth, trapping us in for the foreseeable future. You don't want to know how bad it could be on Earth.